Welcome students to the next class. We are discussing the income from salary head under the income tax law. And yesterday we are discussing perquisites. Yes, among the perquisites, we have discussed perquisites taxable for all employees. And for in that section, first we have discussed rent-free accommodation. In the last class, we discussed about the rent-free accommodation. And what are in the rent-free accommodation? It is, we have to look whether house is owned by the employer or house is hired by the employer. If house is owned by the employer, then we have also considered the population of the locality where the person is. If the population of that locality is below 10 lakhs, then 7.5% of his salary is to be taken as taxable rent-free accommodation perquisite. If population is more than 10 lakhs and up to 25 lakhs, then 10% of salary should be taken as taxable perquisite for rent-free accommodation. If population is above 25 lakhs, then 15% of salary is to be taken as taxable perquisite for rent-free accommodation. All these three cases is generally for the unfurnished houses. If houses are furnished, then I have told you that 10% of cost of furniture or higher size, if it is higher, the furnishers are higher, should be added with the unfurnished value of accommodation, then we will get the furnished value of accommodation. So these are in case of non-government employee we have discussed. Earlier we have also discussed about the government employees. We have to consider license fees or rent of the same locality houses should be taken into consideration. If license fees is given, first we have to take the license fees. If it is not given, then we have to go through the rent of the same type of house in the same locality, which should be taken as taxable perquisite. Here also 10% cost of furniture should be added with the unfurnished value to determine the furnished value of rent-free accommodation for government employee. Non-government, I have told you, in case of non-government employee, if rent-free accommodation was provided to the employee and the house was taken by the employer on hire, in that case, 15% of salary or actual rent paid by the employer, whichever is less, is to be taken as taxable perquisites. Yes, we have discussed in details yesterday. Again, in case of hotel accommodation, I have told you, actual rent paid, actual hotel charges paid, and 24% of salary, whichever is less. Yes, here salary means what? I have told you, salary is generally for different purpose. Salary may be different as per income tax law. Here on calculation of rent-free accommodation, salary means salary, basic salary plus DA if enter. I have given you the meaning of enter. Enter, that means which is entered into the retirement benefit. Basic salary plus DA, which enter, plus commission on turnover, plus fees, plus bonus, plus all taxable allowances, plus all taxable portion of partially taxable allowances. Yes, leave and cash spend pertaining to the current year, entertainment allowance, taxable portion. So all these to be added separately and determined on the basis of that value of salary, we have to take the 10%, 7.5%, 15%, etc. Okay, these we have discussed yesterday. And again, I also solved a problem. Simply I have given a problem of government employee. Today I will try to solve a small problem on rent-free accommodation for non-government employee. Suppose Mr. X getting Mr. X his monthly salary, monthly, name of the person is Mr. X, monthly salary was rupees 12,000 per month. Yes, monthly salary rupees 12,000 per month, and he is residing in a place, suppose New Jalpaiguri of West Bengal. He is at New Jalpaiguri. West Bengal, where population below 10 lakhs. Yes, as per last census. Yes, Mr. X, who is a employee, private sector employee, Mr. X, who is a private sector employee, he is private sector employee, monthly salary 12,000 per month. He is in New Jalpaiguri of West Bengal, where population below 10 lakhs as per the last census. Yes, he gets 50% of, he gets DA, which is 50% of his basic, that is basic salary. Yes, DNS allowance enters into the retirement benefit. Yes, you got the point, I think. Yes, and he is provided by employer a rent-free house by the employer. Yes. Again, he is given rupees 400 as allowance for his sign. Yes, for his sign. He is given rupees 400 allowance for his sign. And suppose cost of furniture is rupees 25,000. Yes, cost of furniture is rupees 25,000. So determine rent-free accommodation value. Determine perquisite of rent-free accommodation. Perquisite of rent-free accommodation then free accommodation, and calculate gross salary. Yes? So it is a simple problem I have given you. I will solve this one. Mr. X, he was a private sector employee. Yes? Monthly salary rupees, that means basic salary rupees 12,000 per month. And he is at New Jalpaiguri, West Bengal, where population below 10 lakh as per last census. He gets DA, which is 50% of his basic salary. And another point is given, DA enters into the retirement benefit. Yes, he is provided a rent-free house by the employer. He is given rupees 400 as allowance for his children, for education of his child, for education of his, suppose his child, education of his child. He is given rupees 400 as allowance for education of his child. Cost of furniture is rupees 25,000. Determine perquisite of rent free accommodation and calculate his gross salary. Yes, gross salary. So we will go to calculate the gross salary of Mr. X. Calculation of gross salary of Mr. X. This rent accommodation is most important one. So I am solving one problem of government employee as well as non-government employee, which will help you. So it is the then chart and what is basic salary or basic salary rupees 12,000 per month into 12. That means 1,44,000. Yes. And what was he in New Jalpaiguri? Yes, you know. 10 lakh below population, he was provided an entry house. We will discuss later on. Next, he gets DA 50%. You now bring DA, that means DNS allowance. DA enters into the retirement benefits. You write here enter. Yes. DA, how much? 50% of salary. 50% of salary. That means 50% of how? 1,44,000 into 50%. Yes. How much it will be? 72,000. Yes. Next, you go to the rent-free accommodation. No other. He is also given allowance, children education allowance for his child. How much it is given? Children education allowance. How much it is? 400. It is given 400 into 12. That means 4,800 less exempted. How much exempted? As we discussed earlier in the allowance, exempted for one child rupees 100 per month. It is 1,200, 3,600 is taxable. Yes, 3,600 is taxable. Now we calculate the value of rent-free accommodation. Value of rent-free accommodation. Yes. What is this? This is the perquisite. So the population, it is house is owned by the employer. It is not mentioned, it is hired. So it is owned by the employer. We assume that. So if it is population less than 10% or less than 10 lakhs, how much will be? 7.5% will be the taxable. 7.5%. 7.5%. Yes, 0.5% of salary. So what is salary for this purpose? Salary means what? basic salary, that means we have to calculate it separately. 1,44,000 basic salary. Yes. DA, if it is entered, then we have to bring. Here it is entered, we have to bring 72,000. And all taxable portion of allowances. This is children's education loss taxable portion, how much? 3,600. Total, how much it is? 2,19,000 is the salary for this purpose. 7.5% of salary, 7.5% of salary, that means 7.5% of salary of how much? 2,19,600. How much it will be? 2,19,600. 7.5, 16,470. 16,470. Yes? Everything we got the unfurnished value. Then there is a cost of furniture also, 25,000. What we have to do? 10% of cost of furniture. 10% of egg. 10% of cost of furniture. How much? It is 25,000. It is given 25,000. 10% means 2,500. Total value of perquisite how much will be? 07981. Yes, 18,970. Yes, and now we total, no other items are there, so we total it. Now we determine the value of rent free accommodation. It is the value of rent free accommodation taxable portion, and total will be 2,38,570. It will be our gross salary. So we are asked to determine, yes, taxable portion value of rent free accommodation and gross salary. It is just I simply solve the problem. What is 2,38,570 is the gross salary. In this way, we have to calculate the rent-free accommodation of non-government employee. I am giving you one example. Okay, it is common one, so I am giving the example of that. We are discussing perquisite taxable for all employees. Next point is perquisite taxable for all employees. We have to discuss another point is concessional rent accommodation. Concessional rent accommodation. Yes, concessional rent accommodation means sometimes number two is taxable for all of the concessional rent accommodation. Yes, what is this? Concessional rent accommodation means it is also perquisite. Sometimes employee is allotted a house as a free, but a portion of payment is to be made by the employer, not totally free. If house is provided to the employee by the employer, but employee pays something in the name of rent. Suppose the value of the rent of the house is suppose 15,000, it should be rupees 15,000 per month. But employee pays rupees 5,000. Yes, balance 10,000 is paid by employer. Yes, So here it is called consciousness. Total rent is suppose 15,000 and employee himself paid 5,000 and 10,000 paid by the employer on behalf of employee. It is called concessional rent accommodation here. So actual rent of accommodation minus less amount paid by employee. Yes, employee amount paid by employee, the balance will be taxable. Yes, if house is given to employee not fully free, a portion of the rent of the house is paid by the employee himself. In that case, what portion he has paid to the employer for the house should be deducted from the total rent or value of the house, and balance will be treated as concessional rent accommodation perquisite value. Okay, I think you got the point. And next point is taxable for all employees. We are discussing perquisite taxable for all employees. Yes, perquisite taxable for all employees. Next we have to discuss about the what point. It is any amount of life insurance premium paid by the employer for life of the number 3. LIC premium of employee paid by the employer. It is also perquisite. Thus, if any LIC premium on behalf of employee, employer paid, it is called as perquisite. So, it is to be taxable for all employees. Whatever amount employer paid for the policies of the employee should be taken as taxable perquisite. Next point is value of specified security. Securities provided by employee to the employer to employee provided to employee by the employer. Suppose sometimes there are different schemes. These schemes are shares and the company's shares are generally given to the employee on concessional rate. Yes, suppose value of the share, market value of the share is, market value of the share of share suppose is rupees 400, and this share is given to the employee on concessional rate, a concessional amount on concession, suppose you can say at rupees 300, and share to employee suppose at rupees 300, balance 100. Yes, this benefit here, actually the employee gets the benefit of rupees 100, because otherwise if he passes the share, he has to pass for 400. So this securities or shares provided by the employer to employee in any scheme, so this benefit which is given to the employee should be taken as taxable perquisite. Taxable is rupees 100. Yes, I think you got the point. And it is the another point. And next point is contribution to effort superannuation fund. Contribution by the employer to the approved super annuation fund. Sometimes, what is super annuation fund? Super annuation fund means any fund which is created for the retirement benefit. Suppose at the time of retirement, employee will get the benefit of this superannuation fund. In that fund, if employer provides something, it should be always taken as taxable, subject to, if he subject to the condition that if he exceeds rupees 1,50,000. Yes, if employer contribution to superannuation fund of employee is more than 1,50,000, then balance will be taxable. Suppose employer contributes 1,00,000 rupees, 1,80,000. Yes, exemption limit is 1,50,000. Taxable will be 30,000. It is taxable. Yes, taxable will be 30,000. So above 1,50,000, any contribution by employer to the superannuation fund is taxable. Pardon me. Yes, above rupees 1,50,000. Yes, it is another point. Next point is other fringe benefit. Other fringe benefit. Fringe benefit means what? Fringe benefit means what? Fringe benefit is actually additional benefit. If it is given along with other benefits, it is fringe benefit. What are the fringe benefit? Suppose interest on concessional rate. Suppose employer may provide interest at concessional rate on loan provided by the employer. Suppose the employer provided some loan at a concessional rate to the employee, in that case this fringe benefit will be taxable according to the LPI rate of interest. LPI rate of interest on different loans. So we have to go through the LPI rate list which is given to your book. And rate is generally changing depending upon the RBI circular. So on the basis of LPI rate, we have to calculate it. And traveling and touring. Traveling and touring expenses. So if these are provided by the employer as additional benefit, so these are actually actual expenditure, actual amount paid by the employer minus actual amount paid by my employer, employee paid or recovered. Suppose here actual amount paid by employer minus employee paid anything. If he himself paid anything, should be deducted, and actual amount which is provided by the employer should be, balance will be taken as taxable purposes. So there are various items, food, beverage, facility, same thing. Actual should be provided by the employee. Employee expenses something should be deducted. In this way, other things also, credit card facility, club facility, use of movable assets, transfer of movable assets, any other benefits, these are fringe benefits. So simply, these are the perquisite taxable for all employees. Yes, now we will discuss about the perquisite taxable for specified employees. partly the taxable for specified employee. I have told you what is who is specified employee. Yes, I have discussed about the specified employee. Specified employee means who is a director of the company or who has interest of, that means who has 20% share of the shareholding into the company or whose monetary benefit above how much? Above 50,000 or after deducting all. So these are the partially taxable for specified employees. These are the specified employees, which is called a specified employee. There are some partulities which are taxable for specified employee only. Specified employees, yes. Partulities taxable for specified employees. Who are specified employees? Who is director of the company? Who has 20% holding of the shares into the company or whose monetary benefit is above 50,000? Yes, after all, deduction. These are actually called as specified employees. What are the items to be taken as specified employees? Yes, specified, in case of specified employee, number one is motor car perquisite. It is most important. Yes, motor car perquisite. It is most important one because it is generally common. So motor car, we have to discuss about the motor car perquisite. Yes. So what is the motor car perquisite? You know motor car? That means if motor car is provided by the employer to the employee, then it is, if he use this one, it is called motor car perquisite. So any expenses incurred by the employer should be taxable in the hands of employee. So here some rules, so we have to follow the rules. The first one is, if motor car is owned by the employer, yes, employer, and running and maintenance expenses is borne by employer. Yes, that means motor car is there, motor car is provided, the expenditure of running the motor car is also provided by the employer. Expenses are borne by the employer or provided by the employee. In that case, what the, if it is office use, yes, if it is only official use, this car is used only for office. The motor car is provided by the employer, and running and maintenance expenses also incurred by the employer, the borne by the employer. If it is only for office use, then no perquisite is to be charged. If this motor car used to coming, going to and coming from office, then it is not to be taken as taxable perquisite. If motor car used for only for personal use, that means the employee may use the motor car not only for official use but also for personal use. If he is not using the car for official use but using the car for only personal use, in that case, actual expenses incurred by the employer. Incurred by employer on running and maintenance, this amount should be first taken into consideration. Yes, and we with that, a diverse salary, if any, diverse salary, if any, with that, and a 10% of cost of car, motor car. Yes, 10% of cost of motor car is depreciation charge. Yeah, and totally. Yes, 10% of cost of car, you got it? And if any amount served by the employer from employee should be deducted, less any amount served by the employer from employee, from the employee should be deducted. Yes, and we get the amount of taxable party. Yes, taxable party with the motor car. First one is, if it is used only for office, then no party is to be signed. If where running and maintenance expenses of car is provided by the employer, running and maintenance expenses are also incurred by the employer. If it is used only for personal use, the actual expenses incurred by the employer for running and maintenance of the car, with that diverse salary to be added, and 10% cost of motor car, that means depreciation charge is to be added, with that amount, if any amount realized from employee should be deducted, a balance will be taken as taxable partnership. Yes, it is for the, if car is owned by the employer, yes, running and maintenance expenses also incurred by the employer. You should keep in your mind. And another point is, it will be here, used for both official and personal. Yes, but for both official and personal use. Yes, this point. Now we will discuss this point. Yes, I wrap this one. I bring this one to top. I think it will be helpful for me to write. Okay, for both official and personal use. If car is provided by the employer, yes, and running and maintenance expenses are incurred by the employer, then if car is used for both official and personal, then we have some problem how we can bifurcate it. So there is a rule given in the income tax law. What is the rule? So we have to go for a capacity of the car. One is up to up to 1.6 liter cubic capacity. One. Another is more than 1.6 liter cubic capacity. That means there, which is 1.6 liter up to 1.6 liter cubic capacity, taken as small car, it is taken as big car. Yes, it is taken as small car, taken as big car. So rule is given, up to 1.6 liter cubic capacity car, how much it will be? Rupees 1800 per month is to be taken as taxable per unit. Yes, if it exceeds or more than 1.6 liter cubic capacity, the car, then it will be 2400 per month. Yes, 2400 per month. Yes, you keep in your mind that if car is owned by the employer, running and maintenance expenses are incurred by the employer, then only up to the 1.6 liter cubic capacity per month chargeable per unit will be 1800, and more than 1.6 liter cubic capacity chargeable per unit will be 2400 per month. Along with that, a whatever may be, either it or a whatever a driver's salary rupees 900 per month. Yes, should be added to determine the taxable per unit. Yes, we here if driver is provided by the employer. Driver is provided by the employer. Yes, it is the point. I think if car is owned by the employer, if car and running and maintenance expenses are also borne by the employer, car is used for both official and personal purpose, yes, then up to 1.6 liter cubic capacity of car, 1800 per month is to be charged at taxable per unit, and more than 1.6 liter cubic capacity car, that means big car, ₹2400 per month is to be charged as taxable per unit. If driver is provided by the employer, driver salary should be added with the value of anyone. Yes, next, on that one point is, one note you have to write here. If expenses of running and maintenance of car for private or personal use is incurred by the employee himself. Yes, employee himself. In that case, it is to some extent different. Same thing, car is owned by the employer, but if he used the car for both official and personal use, the expenses which are incurred for personal use is generally bear by the employee himself. For personal use, how much he used the car, for that portion he bearing the expenses himself. In that case, you have to up to 1.6 liter capacity of car, this 1800 should be ₹600 per month, because here for use of car for personal purpose, the expenses are bear by the employee himself, so it is reduced, and more than 1.6 liter capacity car, it is ₹900 per month. And driver salary, if driver is provided by the employer, then a driver salary ₹900, yes, if provided by employer. Yes, so these are the points you have to keep in your mind, because it's a common one, this perquisite, motor car perquisite. Therefore, if motor car is owned by the employer and Motor is owned by the employer and running and maintenance expenses are borne by the employer. In that case, we have to go, if it is used only for official use, then no perquisite there. If it is used for both official as well as official, only for official is no perquisite. If it is used only for personal use, then we have to add actual expenditure incurred by the employer, add yes, salary of driver, add 10% of depreciation on the cost of the car, less any expenses recovered for the employee should be deducted if it is used only for personal purpose. If it is used both for official as well as personal purpose, then we have to look who bear the expenses. If running and maintenance expenses bear by the employer, then car also owned by the employer up to 1.6 point cubic capacity, a small car, ₹1800 per month, more than 1.6 liter cubic capacity, 2400 per month, and driver salary should be added 900 per month if provided by the employer. Then one point is there, if the car is used for both official and personal use, but only expenses which are incurred for personal purposes are bear by the employee himself, but incurred by the employee himself, in that case, the 1.6 liter capacity will be 600, reduced from 1800 to 600, and more than 1.6 liter capacity reduced from 2400 to 900. Thus, driver salary should be added ₹900 if it is paid by the driver, is provided by the employer. Another point is, so one is, if car is owned by the employer, running and maintenance expenses are borne by the employer. Now you get the another point of motor car. Yes. Number 2 point is that, yes, motor car owned by the employee himself, owned by the employee, that means not provided by the employee, motor car owned by the employee. In that case, if it is official use, yes, if expenses are here, we have to go, who bear the expenses? The expenses by employee himself. And if expenses are by employer, by expenses incurred by employer. Yes, if expenses by employer or if expenses by employee, if car is owned by the employee. In that case, if it is official use, no perquisite there, because it is his own car, he using for go to office and coming from office, no perquisite. If it is private use, if employee, if car is his own, he used for his personal use, then no need for employees to give the, take it as a taxable perquisite. But if it is, these expenses are bear by the employer, the expenses of this car, which is owned by the employee, bear by the employer, yes, in that case, what actual amount, from employer, yes, how much amount he has given to employee for running and maintenance, actual amount from employer minus any amount recovered from employee should be deducted and balance will be taxable or in the hands of employee as a taxable perquisite. Yes? And if it is for both official and personal use, actual expenditure Yes, it was for official and personal use. Official and personal use. Here in that case, if expenses are bear by the employee himself, no need. If expenses are by the employer, all are by the employer, in that case, same for up to 1.6 liter car, it is 1800 per month, and more than 1.6 liter car, rupees 2500 per month. Yes, and actually in that case you have to show you corrective. In that case, actual expenditure, minus for 1.6 liter capacity, rupees 1800 or up to, you can say up to, and more than 1.6 liter capacity, rupees 2400. Yes, and plus 8 rupees plus driver salary, rupees 900. Yes, you first actual expenditure incurred by the employer, this one you have to either deduct up to one small car 1800 per month and big car for 2400 per month, and after deducting this, what you will get, this with balance, this 900 driver salary should be added, you get that taxable portion of perquisite for motor car. So it is, if car is owned by the employee, if expenses are incurred by the employee and expenses are incurred by the employer. Expenses are incurred by the employee for official use, no. If it is incurred by the employer also official use, no perquisite. And for private use, if it is for private use, if it is expenses by the employee, so it is no need, because he has spent money for running and maintenance on his own car, so no need to take on his perquisite. If it is expenses are bear by the employer, then actual amount from employer for running and maintenance charges minus any amount recovered from employee should be deducted, balance will be taxable perquisite. If it is used both for official and personal use, then it is expenses bear by the employee himself, no need to show as a perquisite. If it is used for both official and personal use, but expenses are bear by the employer, in that case actual expenditure which are incurred by the employer and less up to 6 point capacity, 1800 per month, and for more than 1.6 liter capacity, 2400 per month, and balance will be added with the driver salary of 900 per month if driver is provided by the employer. So these are the, simply I have given you the rules for calculating the motor car perquisite in different situation. So it is a common one. So this perquisite is taxable for specified employees only. There are other specified employees perquisite I will discuss in the next class for other perquisite for specified employees, and again we will go to the discussion on profit in lieu of salary under section 17(3). Thank you for today.